Hi, this is Sai Morton with the daily update on Eurofix. I post my exclusive market overviews with the key political and economical events, charts and important levels on the ForexBSami.com forums weekly. This short video is a response to rapidly changing situation on the currency markets and should help you to stay on top of the game and be profitable. I suggest you to visit ForexBSami.com forum and read my analysis for the week before watching this daily video.
Welcome everybody guys, let's take a look again on markets. So we're back after the holidays. Today even in Europe the exchanges are open. So the market gradually is turning back to activity after the holidays. And you can see right in the beginning of the year significant action across the board. So when the Great British Pound retracement has started, then we discussed on the 31st of December in our trading session in the previous year. Gold market is continuing upward action, confirming our view that it's not just occasional action. We see the big money flows beyond of this, on the background of this action, because market just ignored all resistance areas, whatever strength that they are. So it's just shows upward action. Bitcoin market, the setup that we have talked with the ABCD retracement also shows the reaction, and market turned to the upward action today. Finally, on euro currency, the retracement that we have talked about finally started. So indeed, market shows the reaction on the resistance, this 12-8 area. And you can see yesterday it was significant pullback out from this level. So because this is actually, guys, straight up a stretch. You can see that despite the trend stands bullish, this is bearish directional patterns. It's a combination of the daily over bond and major FIB level. So some reaction has to happen, so it's really big chances on the reaction, and you can see it now is falling down. So for the daily traders, currently, well, you probably should wait on a good moment for taking the long position, because at least by far we treat this action as retracement. Taking into consideration the strength of this retracement, I'm not excluding the way if it will be two-leg retracement, kind of the ABCD pullback, that's also possible. So in this case this will be good scenario for daily traders, because this will be garbage cheaper to buy right on the daily chart. So compounding retracement really has happened here. If not, well, in this case we'll keep an eye on the lower time frames and see how market will respond on the major support areas. Once we'll get good response, we'll get bullish reversal patterns somewhere. That will be the situation that we will be able to use for taking the long position. Currently, as reaction just started on the daily chart, probably we have nothing to do, so I just turn to the intraday charts. So that's been said, on the daily, those who trade on the daily charts should wait and see what will happen around major intraday supports and see where the good situation will be for taking the long position. On the intraday charts, guys, currently we could consider setup that we discussed. So this is a kind of the bread and butter setup. This market actually, it's not quite bread and butter, by the way. The problem here is with the too extended downward action a bit. But by the nature, it carries the features of the bread and butter, because we have the good thrusting upward action. And within the straight downward action, market hits right here, 30% support. So here we need to drop our time frame more and see what will happen around this area. So if we will get clear bullish reversal patterns on the 15-minute chart, maybe, then it's probably could mean that we could get here significant retracement. So at least 618 pullback of the whole downward action. If no response here will happen, it will mean that we're coming to the next support area, 1133. And now it seems that it's also possible, because you can see market is tending to break this area totally and trying to downward action. The one thing that, guys, I have some doubts on this setup, because theoretically you could treat it as a double repo as well, because take a look at this thrust action. This was the first close below the 3x3. If we could generally accept this difference between the tops, and this looks really like the capitulation of the bulls, because it was sharp downside reversal immediately. It's probably you also will get the divergence with the MACD, and it's also it has happened right at the major resistance on the daily. It means that here you also will be correct if you will treat this as double repo, and the double repo has been confirmed on the second clause below the 3x3. Overall price action also corresponds to the idea of the double repo, because for the brand buyer has to reach major support with the three clause below the 3x3. But you can see that it has reached on the fourth clause. Well, and in the current situation, it's a bit difficult to set a total. That's why we think that to get the answer on this question, we need to keep an eye on what is going on in intraday charts. So take a look on the hourly chart. On the hourly chart, guys, that's our setup. Just a few minutes ago, I put the COP, and that was the reason why I think that market has to create the new low. Currently, market hits the COP with this downward action, and take a look. The extension of this minor retracement stands at 127 right here. So here we could talk about the minor butterfly pattern. Also, we have the features of the bearish dynamic pressure. Consider this flat action or even the downward action while the trend stands bullish by the MACD. It means that definitely these lows has to be taken out, and that has happened just a few seconds ago. Downward action here looks relatively strong, and it means that we could get a bit more action to the downside. Let's first keep an eye on the 1618 extension of this butterfly. What will happen around it? It stands right here, right around the MACD. So this is the setup that we will keep an eye on right now. So what we need to do next, as we write on before now our eyes, you can see market passing for this level and hitting the 1618. Our major riddle here, what we would like to understand, is whether the market will reverse up here. And as I said, since we have the price behavior that is actually typical as for a bread and butter, as for double repo, we need more confirmation, we need more patterns that could confirm one or another point of view. And here, as we already spicing lower, I think that the one pattern that we could keep an eye on is minor head and shoulders. So take a look at this pattern, guys, within a few hours. That will tell you whether the market will show the upward bounce to the 618 resistance or not. And that simultaneously will answer your question whether you need to take the position or not. Because butterflies very often becomes the part of the head and shoulders pattern. So it means that currently what we will keep an eye on, we need to pull back right back up to this area. 1181. Then some retracement again has to happen back to this area, approximately this low, 1165, somewhere in this level. So you just could recognize by the hand shoulder pattern by yourself. So just keep an eye on the bottom of the right arm. If you want to take the long position, if indeed this pattern will be formed here, well, that will be the chance to go long with the target approximately 618 fib level of the whole downward action. That's our short-term view and scalp for the scalp trading. Once the 618 level will be reached, well, as I said, I'm not excluding the chance that there will be more deeper retracement, compounding retracement. There, we'll see what will happen. Also, guys, you theoretically could try to take the position right here with some part of your trading volume, because in this point, you could place real very tight stop. You could place stop slightly below this area. Why? Because if market will start to form something, it probably will hold these lows, because that potential will be the bottom of the hand and shoulders head. If not, then market probably will collapse directly right from here. So from that standpoint, I call these areas as a culmination points. So they provide you best risk-reward ratio. Although they do not guarantee you success, it may be not reliable, not as reliable as dealing with the clear pattern, but it provides you perfect risk-reward ratio. And sometimes you could take the minor part of your trading volumes, for example, 25%, 30%, with the taking position here and see what will happen. If indeed hand shoulders will start to form, you will get the rest half of your position or part of your position right at the bottom of the right arm and be involved with the two parts of the position without protection. So that's what we will keep an eye on today's session. This is the setup for the scalp traders. Because currently you can see market stands at the support, market hits the extensions, so this relatively good support area. And now we'll need to take a look what will happen, whether the bullish pattern will be formed or not. For daily traders, as I said, just keep watching. make attempt for taking the positions. You also could use this setup for taking the long position, because we do not know whether this will be definitely compound retracement or not. And let's see what will happen.